Hey everyone, John here. In this super fast sneak peek, I'm going to show you how I built one of the presets that's going to be shipping in the latest version of Sapphire, version 2023.5. So hold on to your hats and let's jump in. So one of the great things about creating presets is you get to name your own presets, and I've named this one Caustics Portal because the base of this preset is the Caustics effect. Here inside Sapphire Effect Builder, you can see it's a pretty big effect. Let's just roll into the top and we'll just fly through this. So the very first effect is Sapphire Color, just to create a black background because this works best on black. That's followed by Caustics. Caustics is my favorite water generation effect inside Sapphire. I use it for a lot of my animated backgrounds. And I followed that with Sapphire Warp Polar. And you can see this has warped that into a circle. Now, that's followed by Sapphire Distort, and that's just giving a nice distortion effect here. But notice how I've got some other effects piped into the lens port of the distort effect. And that's starting with Clouds Perspective. Now, Clouds Perspective can be used to create perspective clouds, of course, but I've actually followed it with Warp Polar and animated it so that it's moving from the middle outwards. And because I'm using that as a lens for distort, I'm getting distortion that moves from the center outwards. That's followed by Sapphire Shape, and Sapphire Shape's combined is set to multiply, and that's just feathering out those edges. Beneath that, I have Sapphire Layer, and notice how the checkerboard got filled. That's because in the background, I'm using just another S color effect just to fill in those transparent areas. Now on the other side, we have Sapphire Parallax Strips, another great generator effect inside of Sapphire. And I've set this to show strips over black. And I've combined it with a second Parallax Strips using Sapphire Layer and the Overlay Blend Mode. And each of them is animating in the opposite direction, which gives a really interesting effect. Beneath that, we have Sapphire Warp Polar again, which features very heavily in this preset. And that gives us this nice sort of tech circle look. Very geometric looking. Beneath that we have S Gradient Radial, and I'm just using black and white. So black is the outer, white is the inner, and I've got combined set to multiply, and I've increased the noise. You see I've added some noise in there. Now above that we have Sapphire Texture Flux, another great noise effect, which also kind of looks like water. And that's been placed over the top using the Overlay Blend Mode. And I like the combination of the sort of organic looking water effect with those sharp geometric lines. On top of that, we have a little bit of Sapphire Bokeh Lights. It's kind of a little sneaky little particle look in there. And we follow that with S Distort again, but notice how the distortion is isolated to the center of the look. And that's because we're using S Shape. So the same mask in the matte port to isolate that to the center. So that's the right-hand side. And if we look at how we combine those using S Layer, and there we go. So we've combining the Caustics distortion look with the Parallax Strips distortion look, and we're getting a really lovely, beautiful layered look. Now beneath that, we have S Quad Tone, really quick way to add some lovely color tones to that. And beneath that, we have S Layer, and that's combining the Sapphire 2023.5 logo, and that's been set up as the mask inside After Effects, which is the host I'm using. And I've just used a little bit of Warp Transform just to slide that across so that the logo is in the center. And to finish off, a little bit of Ultra Glow, or maybe a lot of Ultra Glow. And you can see what a difference Ultra Glow makes to that look. All right, so did you catch all that? I know it was lightning fast, but I just wanted to give you a taste of just one of the presets that's shipping with Sapphire 2023.5. We have other presets coming too, and also we'll have tutorials and a deep dive into all of the new features that are included in the upcoming version. For now, this is John from Boris Effects. I'll see you in another tip.